So we're starting the summer here in Oslo, and then we're doing a huge loop all the way through Europe, and we're ending in Edinburgh in August, and we're doing a special New Girl Dream show. How does it feel to be doing the album in its entirety?
You always want a great way to end a finale, and even just playing in Edinburgh at that time of the year, the festival, it'd be such a vibe.
So Gordy, we're going to be playing this, you know, this epic gig in August in Edinburgh, playing New Girl Dream.
I remember buying that album back in the day when it first came out. I remember where I was living, I remember the flat I was living in, and I always remember the album. It was a kind of soundtrack to a period of my life.
The entirety sounds like a very extensive work. In fact, it's a short album. There's only 9 songs, one of which is an instrumental. However, within the realms of Simple Minds, within our story, it was our breakthrough album. Critically, it's the most appreciated. And for a lot of fans, it was the gateway into Simple Minds.
I was living in a squat in London, and New Girl Dream came out, and I was obsessed with the record because the feeling it gave me was optimism, possibility, yeah. Travel, yeah. Like travelling through Europe on a train. There was this movement about the whole record.
So we're going to be playing New Girl Dream in Edinburgh at the end of the tour. Bring back any memories?
Yeah, this Cherisse. It's a funny album because it's, you know, it's so delicate, New Girl Dream, and when you're playing it live, you sort of, one of the hardest things is just to keep it delicate so you don't push it, you know, and it gets too robust and starts to, you know, lose that kind of gentleness that it has.
So I'm really looking forward to performing in Colours Fly and King is White in the Crowd. That's the type of Simple Minds that I absolutely lose my mind at.
Playing these songs from New Girl Dream,
yep.
Does it bring up any memories, you know, from that time?
That's a great thing about music, it's what it evokes, and that album particularly and those songs, funny enough, takes us back to where we are now. While we were recording New Girl Dream, we were also out, I think for the first time, playing in festivals. It was, you know, because we were just at that stage where the band was getting a reputation. So for instance, the title track of New Girl Dream itself, the working title is called Festival Song.
Oh really?
That was working title before it, because we had this tune, we must have played it at sound checks at festivals.
For me, New Girl Dream is just a fantastic sounding record. It's really atmospheric, it's dreamlike, it's more like a piece of work,
you know,
like one, like one song in a way, you know,
yes.
Like a journey.
A mood.
It's a mood.
Yeah.
So for me, the drum parts are really, you know, they're really unique, they're really out of the box, they're very unorthodox, the way the drummer was playing on the record, the parts are kind of backwards, so for me, I'm just loving learning these parts and being inspired by these parts. What is it about the album that you think makes it special?
It's very vibrant, it's fresh, it is of the time, but then like going through them now, I mean they're current, they sound really modern. They still have that vibrant energy, don't you think?
They still sound that timeless way. And you can't say that with a lot of music from that era. From that period, some of it hasn't dated, whereas I always think those songs have dated so well, or they haven't dated, you know what I mean, they're as current sonically and everything now than they were then. They still give me that excitement, that kind of thing there. Je ne sais quoi.
It's not just we're playing New Girl Dream for no reason, it is the 40th anniversary. Everything just seems to have just sort of fitted right. You know, the idea of doing it, the music itself, the cause, of course, back in March when the war first started, like everyone else, we looked around and said, you know, what can we do to help in our own little way?
Because obviously we're doing, you know, one of the gigs is for Ukraine to raise money. How do you feel about that?
it's heartbreaking, absolutely. Do I want to be, to me, to be able to sing at a concert that's going to raise money, I'm going to sing with all I have.
I think that's the main point, is that what can you do as a musician, right? Yeah. What can we do as a band?
Yeah.
It's just, to me, it's like, well, that's a really apt way to support the people of Ukraine. And I think everyone is invested in that. And if we can do it through music, then you know, that's our natural.
Yeah.